Hey guys, John Thompson, Spring Framework Guru. I'm going to show you today how easy it is to create a Spring Boot project, and we're going to use this going forward in the tutorial. So I've got IntelliJ up on my desktop. I'm going to go in to New and then to Project. And I'm going to come over here and select the Spring Initializer. There's a URL. You can go to this website as well to download a configured project for you. I'm going to use it through the IntelliJ IDE. So I'm just going to click the next button here. Comes up. I'm going to give it a name. We're going to use Maven, packages jar, Java 1.8. Give a description here. Now I'm going to go to the next page. I've got the settings set up here. And we are going to want to use Spring Security, Spring Web. We're going to use Thymely for the front end. And JPA. And we want an H2 database in here. So this will give us a good starter for a very basic web application where we can do a CRUD type operations. Click Next. Give me the project name, Spring Boot Web App. I'm going to save it out to my hard drive. Click Finish. I'm on a dual monitor setup. It just went to the wrong monitor, brought it back over. So we're going to add this as a Maven project. And now we can see what the Spring Initializer created for us. So the default project package is Spring Boot, Spring Boot Web Application. So a couple things I want to change here. That was my mistake on the previous. So I just refactored the package name there to, that was a mistake I made on the previous Spring screen. So we can see that we have this application up. We can actually run it. And I expect this is going to error out because it doesn't have any templates, but we'll see. Thymely blows up right now. So that's the initial thing that we need to do is add in the templates. I'm going to do that as we go forward in the tutorial. So this was just a real quick example of creating a application using the Spring Initializer. You can see that I have a fully configured Java project using Maven. Take a look at the Maven POM. So it brought in all our dependencies for us. You can see the database test. It's also using the Maven plugin. So this video recording is part of a tutorial series over at my blog, springframework.guru. Please follow along there. This is just the first step of creating the project. I'm going to go through in conjunction with a series on the blog to show you how to create a web application using Spring Boot. So we're going to build this out and have a basic CRUD application as we get this tutorial rolling. So I hope you appreciate these videos. If you do, please like the video or go over to Facebook and show us a little social media love and like our Facebook page. Thanks, John Thompson, Spring Framework Guru.